In this section, we will discuss about the new feature, that is the VPC auto recovery feature. Okay, so the very first case that we are going to discuss, this case we already discussed in our previous scenario, right? So when the VPC peer link goes down, and the impact of that will be that the secondary device is going to shut down all the VPC member ports plus the VPC VLAN SVIs, right? So once a secondary device takes this action, and after some time, let's say the primary fails completely. So in that case, in our previous scenario, when there was no auto recovery feature, so our secondary device keeps the ports or the keeps the VPC member ports down and all the SVIs also until the primary comes back, okay? But when we use the auto recovery feature into VPC, then this problem will be resolved. You can see here that once the VPC peer link is down and after some time the primary fails completely. So in the bullet point, you can see if three consecutive peer keep live messages are lost, then the secondary device will become the primary and all the VPC ports and SVIs related to the VPC VLAN, they will be functional. Okay, and let's say after this situation, after some time the primary comes back again online, then it will be it will becomes the secondary. Hence it means that the roles are now reversed. So the secondary so earlier before this situation, the device that was secondary is now the primary, and the device which was playing the role of primary now becomes the secondary. So the roles are now reversed. Now let's see this with a practical also. Okay, so this is our N7K2. If I do a show VPC role, so N7K2 is the primary device, and if I check on N7K1, so N7K1 is the secondary device. Now we need to enable the auto recovery feature. So if I do a show VPC, if I go a little up, so we can see here that the auto recovery status is disabled. By default, it is disabled. So we need to enable this feature. So how we can enable it? We need to go to VPC domain, and then we just need to say auto recovery. Okay. Let's do it on both sides. VPC domain 1, auto recovery. Let's save the configuration on both sides. Now if I do a show run VPC, so now our auto recovery feature is enabled. If I do a show VPC again, now you can see that the auto recovery status is enabled. Okay. Now let's check it on N7K1 also. If I do a show VPC, so the auto recovery status is enabled. And N7K1 is the secondary device, if I'm not wrong. Show VPC rule, right? Let's bring down the peer link first. Interface port channel 1, shut down. So our peer link is down, and this is the secondary device. So as per the default behavior, because the peer keep alive link is up, so it is going to shut down all the VPC member ports plus the SVI VLANs related to the VPC VLAN. Swipe interface brief. Now we can see all our SVIs are down, VLAN 10, 20 and 30. And if I do a show port channel summary, port channel 2 and 3 both are down, right? If I do a show VPC, port channel, I mean VPC 2 and VPC 3 both are down. What is the reason? The reason is the peer link is down, right? So now in our previous case, in our previous lecture, we have seen that after this situation, if our primary device fails completely, then all the ports on the secondary device plus the SVIs, they will stay in the down state, okay? Unless your primary device comes back. So now I will go ahead and I will power off the primary device. So N7K2 is the primary device, okay? Show VPC role. So this is the primary device. So I'll go ahead and power off N7K2. So now I have powered off the N7K2. Now if I do a show VPC, now you can see here the type checks were bypassed for the VPC. Now the consistency checks and all, they are bypassed. Okay, and now you can see that consistency is success and status is down. Eventually it will come up, the VPCs. If I do a show IP interface brief, so the status will eventually come up because now we do have the auto recovery feature. If I do a show run VPC, then we have the auto recovery feature on. Now let's wait for some time. Now you can see that port channel 2 or VPC 2, the status is up. VPC 3, port channel 3, status is up. If I do a show port channel summary, now port channel 2 and 3, all the member ports are up. Also, all the SVIs should be up now. Now we can see VLAN 10, 20, and 30, all the three SVIs related to the VPC VLAN, they are up now. In our previous situation, when there was no auto recovery feature, we have seen that your VPC secondary device, all the member ports plus the SVIs, that stays down, and we needed to apply the workaround by removing the VPCs from the ports, right? So when we are using the auto recovery feature, then this is the benefit of that, that we do not need to do anything. It is going to bring up all the VPC member ports plus the SVIs once the device misses the three keep alives. Okay. Now we have case number 5 with auto recovery. So in our previous lecture, we have seen that when both the devices went down and only one comes up, then your VPC was not forming. It was into a known established state, right? Because all these mandatory steps that were not completed, right? That is why all your member ports and your SVIs, they were down. And we needed to apply the same workaround to remove the VPC configuration for that, right? But in this situation, when we do have the auto recovery feature, let's say if you can see the first bullet point, the devices that is up, it will wait till the auto recovery timeout. So the by default, the auto recovery timeout is 24.0 or 240 second. Okay, we can modify this by using the command auto recovery delay restore. We can set it with this command. So by default, the timer is 240 seconds. So once the one of the device comes up, it is going to wait till 240 seconds. And if either VPC peer link comes up or the peer keep alive link come up, then auto recovery will not be triggered. Okay. So within this 240 second, the device which is live now, it is going to check if your VPC peer link is up or your VPC peer keep alive status is up. If nothing happens within this 240 second, then your auto recovery will be triggered, okay? And your device will become the primary and it will bring up all the VPC ports plus the SVIs, okay? Now let's see it with a practical. Before we start our case number 5 that I power off both our Nexus devices and I just bring up only one device. Let us verify our last point also that we discussed, that after this situation, the VPC roles will be reversed. So the device that was before working as a primary device, it will be secondary, and the secondary device will become now the primary. So N7K1 was the VPC secondary device, right? So now if I do a, so now N7K2 is up now. So if I do a show VPC role, so now the N7K1 becomes the operational primary, and N7K2, once it is, because now it is back online, if I do a show VPC role, it was the primary device earlier, now it is the operational secondary. So this also proves our last point, last bullet point that we discussed, that after this situation, the VPC roles will be reversed. Now I will pause the recording, I'll power down both the devices, and then I will just bring up only one device. Let's say I bring up only N7K1, and then we will see if it is going to bring all the VPC member ports and the SVI is up or not. Okay. Also, as we have seen in the bullet points, that we can also change the auto recovery default timer. So we can also do that. If I do a VPC domain 1 auto recovery restore delay, so here we can change it. Let's say I keep it 60 seconds. Okay, value of property auto recovery is out of range. So in this module that I'm using, it is not allowing me to change the auto recovery reload delay timer. Okay, though it is showing that we can set it starting from 60 seconds, but it is not allowing me to set. Okay, I can try it on N7K1 also. VPC domain 1, if I do auto recovery reload delay, let's say I try to set any higher value, 100 maybe. So it is not allowing me, but in your real devices you can set it. So the minimum value that you can set is the 60 seconds. Okay, so if I do a show VPC and if I go up, so the auto recovery feature is now enabled. So I have also shown you how you can change this timer, though it is not allowing me in this EvenG software. So you'll be able to change it in the real environment. Okay. So now I will go ahead and I'll power off both the Nexus devices, and then I will bring up only N7K1. I'll make sure that the auto recovery feature is enabled. Yes, it is enabled, right? Show port channel summary. So everything is working as of now, right? So I'll pause the recording and let me power off both the devices and just bring up N7K1. So now I have power on only N7K1. Okay. So now, as we discussed in our case number 5, that once only one device will comes up, then it is going to wait till the auto recovery timer is expired, right? If I do a show VPC, so the auto recovery timer is by default, it's 240 seconds. So now it is going to wait, right? If I do a show VPC role, so it is going to wait around 4 minutes, right? Show VPC role. Let's wait. Eventually, it will become the primary. So I'll keep the recording on. You can skip it if you want to check the final state of this device, whether it becomes the primary or not. also it is showing us the timer is ongoing here, right? It is showing us that 143 seconds are left. You can see here, right? So after 143 seconds, it is going to bring up all the VPC member ports plus the SVIs if it did not hear anything from the peer device related to VPC peer link or the VPC peer keep alive, right? Show VPC role. Now you can see that it is not going to take any action until the VPC auto recovery timer is expired. Show VPC. Let's check. So still 96 seconds are left. So we'll wait for more 1.5 minutes. So we can see that our port are still down. Okay, and because these timers are given just to avoid any issues, because also your let's say your device is having the WAN connection, right? And from the WAN, it is having some, let's say, BGP neighborship. So it is also going to take some time for this device to synchronize all your routing table and all, right? So it is going to learn all the routes from WAN and all. Because let's say once this device comes back and it doesn't find the other device and it keeps all the, it brings all the ports up, plus all the SVIs, then it will start receiving the traffic from the downstream devices, right? And there is no point if the routing is not conversed from the WAN side, so your traffic will be dropped, right? So depending upon your routing protocols also, you can set this timer. So let's see how much time is left. So 14 seconds are left now. So after 14 second, now 11 second, it is going to pick up the role. Show VPC role. Still it is known established. Show VPC. Now 0 second left. Now it will pick up the role finally. Now you can see that it is the primary device now. So if we go to show port channel summary, so these ports will also eventually come up. By the way, show IP interface brief. So your protocols or line protocols for your SVIs will also come up. Show VPC. By the way, show run VPC. You have the auto recovery feature on, right? Eventually your port channels will come up. You can see that now the VPC 2 and VPC 3 both are up. And if I do a show port channel summary, so now your port channel 2 and port channel 3, all your member ports into the VPC are up. Also your SVIs are up now, right? We learned 10, 20 and 30. We did not remove anything. Your VPC configuration is still there thanks to the VPC auto recovery feature, right? That once your both device went down and only one comes back, because of this feature, all your member ports and your SVIs related to the VPC VLAN, the device is going to bring them up. So these were our two cases that we discussed in our previous lecture without the auto recovery feature and now with the auto recovery feature. Okay, let's also see a quick diagram. Now let's look at this diagram. So our VPC peer link goes down. Okay, so this is a diagram for the case that we discussed today with the auto recovery feature, right? So our VPC peer link is down. Now, what is the role of the device? So if it is a primary device, then it is not going to take any action, right? All the VPC ports plus your SVIs related to the VPC VLAN, they will stay up. So the main thing is going to happen on the secondary device. So if the device is secondary, if the device receives the keep alive, right, then your secondary device will get to know that the primary device is alive, right? So that is why it is going to bring down the VPC member ports and your VPC VLAN SVIs, right? If it did not receive any keep alive for 3 seconds, or if it missed 3 keep alives back to back, then it will assume that the primary device is down, and now it will become the primary device, and it will bring up all the VPC member ports plus the VPC VLAN SVIs. Also, what is the benefit of this feature is that, let's say after this situation, when the secondary device gets to know that the primary device is alive, and it brought down all the VPC member ports and the SVIs, and then after some times your primary fails completely, then again it will go back to this situation. It will wait for 3 keep alives. If it misses 3 keep alives, then it is going to assume that your primary is down, and it will become the primary device. So these were our two cases. In our next section, we will discuss one more failure scenario.